राम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ॐ यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पुरुण एदागश्च प्रणिनोति तस्मै तगुं हरिमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकं संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघरम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। सिंधी एट सूत्र। So the ninth sutra is introduced. There is no introduction, sorry. So ninth sutra has no introduction in the Kṛtātyādhikaraṇam. We saw the eight sutras. Kṛtātyaye anuṣayavān drishtasmṛtibhyām yathetam anevañca. So this jīva has pending karma even after svarga bhoga. And then while he returns with a different path. That is what was mentioned due to the Shruti and Smriti Pramana. Then the Purvapakshi is saying, Charanaditi chen no upalakshanartheti karshna jinihi. Charanaditi chen no upalakshanartheti karshna jinihi. So, charanad iti chet na upalakshanartha iti karshna jinihi. That is a padachheda. So Karshnajini Acharya is refuting the Sutrakara is refuting the objection raised by the Purvapakshi using Karshnajini Acharya's statement. So Charanad, what is said there? The Purvapakshi has said that there is no karma pending for the Jiva because Swarga Bhoga has exhausted the karma. Therefore, there cannot be any punaravrutti for this jiva. So what you are saying is that jala becomes jiva in the panchama ahuti, that is not possible because karma itself is not pending. Then why will jiva come down through any path? To that the answer was given, no, there is shruti and smriti pramana for karma being pending for jiva. Anadikala karma in sanchita is pending, only a part of that is exhausted in swarga. Therefore there is punarjanma, and thereby the panchamahuti jala becoming meaning sukshma sharira sambandha jiva becoming sambandha jala sukshma sharira, that is the jiva which was mentioned as what? Samparishvakta. So samparishvakta, this bhuta samparishvaktasya rahanam, that is established. The jiva who is connected with the sukshma mahabhuta and the pancha ahuti jala becoming jiva, that is definitely so as described. So now the Purvapakshi is charanaditi chet, meaning the karma that is claimed to be pending by the Siddhanti, it is not so. Meaning charanad, acharanat, shilat. Charana here has the meaning of acharana or the shila. Sabhava. Due to that, there is what? There is this janma. So charanat, acharanat iti chet, shilat, swabhavat iti chet, na says the Siddhanti Sutrakara by quoting Karshnajini Acharya's explanation to it. Iti chet na karmanam upalakshanartha iti Karshnajini. So upalakshanartha means this charana, acharana, where it is said ramaniya charanaha. The Purvapakshi is saying ramaniya charanaha. So thereby the utpatti which is mentioned for the jiva, that is on account of conduct. Particular conduct of the jiva will lead to a particular janma. So thereby the birth being a result of conduct of the jiva, this karma that you are claiming to be there in sanchita etc., that has no bearing on Janma. This is the Puropaksha. And the refutation of that is, the answer to such an objection by the Siddhanti is that this Charana, Acharana, Ramaniya Charana, so those who have good conduct will go to Swarga, and then those who have bad conduct will go to Naraka Ityadi. So that Acharana Shabda, Charana means Acharana, that is Upalakshana for Karma. What it means is that a person having good conduct means that one has Dharma Acharana, meaning Dharma Karma. Dharma and Karma are interchangeable in Shastra. So wherever the Shabda Karma is there, that means Dharma. And this Acharana of a particular thing, meaning Ramaniya Acharana, would mean what? It would mean Ramaniya Karma. Dharma, Dharma Acharana, that's what it means, and it means Karma. So it is Upalakshana Artha, says Karshnajini Acharya. That is the Sutra Artha. The Vritti is pretty small there. Nanu Ramaniya Charanaha iti Shrutihi Charanat Yuanya Pattim. Let me cross check that. Doesn't look that, it looks like a typo there. Just let me cross check. No, it is right. So, Yuanyapattim. So, Yoniapattim. So, it is not Yaha, it is Yoniapattim. Yoniapatti, the attainment of a particular Yoni in a particular Janma. And that Yoniapatti itself is called as a Janma. So, he is saying Charanad Yoniapattim Darshayati. So yoni apatti, attainment of a particular yoni meaning a species, that kind of a janma is only due to charana meaning acharana. How do you know that? Ramaniya charana is the shruti, as pramana there says the Puropakshi. So nanu ramaniya charana iti shruti hi charanat yonyapattim darshayati na anushaya. So this anushaya is the claim made by the Siddhanti in the earlier Anushayavan. Jiva is Anushayavan, meaning Shesha Karmavan. That is not so. So Shesha Karmavan Anushayat, due to the Shesha Karma, there is no Janma. The Janma is only due to Acharana. This is what the Puropakshi is saying. Anyat Charanam Anyo Anushayaha iti na Anushaya Siddhir iti Chet. And thereby, what is the Puropakshi saying? This Acharana is different from Shesha Karma. Anyat Charanam, Acharana is different, has a different meaning. And Anyaha Anushaya, Anushaya the Shesha Karma has a different meaning. Conduct and Shesha Karma have no, they are not synonyms of each other. The conduct and Anushaya have different meanings. Iti na Anushaya Siddhir iti Chet. So by saying Charana, Ramaniya Charana, you cannot take Anushaya as the meaning. This is what the Puropakshi is saying. Iti Chet na. Siddhanti says it is not so. Why? Because Karshnajini Acharya takes the Charana to be Upalakshana for Karma also, Shesha Karma also. Yataha Karshnajini Acharya Iyam Charana Shrutihi Anushaya Upalakshanartha iti Manyate. Because Karshnajini Puramimamsaka Acharya considers this Charana Shruti, Ramaniya Charana is the Charana Shrutihi, that Shruti he considers as Upalakshana even for the Anushaya, meaning Shesha Karma. So Jiva has Shesha Karma, therefore he will be born in a particular yoni. Then the Puropakshi takes another route to object. Anarthakyam iti chen na tad apekshatvat. Anarthakyam iti chen na tad apekshatvat. So objection there is anarthakyam. What is the anartha there? He says the Shruti gata charana shabda. The charana shabda in the Shruti. Ramaniya charanaha iti Shruti gata charana shabda. That charana shabda, if it is for upalakshana of, it stands as upalakshana for Shesha Karma Anushaya also, then what will happen? That charana shabda would be meaningless. Shruti gata charana shabdasya ramaniya charanaha iti Shruti gata charana shabdasya anarthakyam iti chet. It would be futile to use Charana Shabda. Why would the Shruti use Charana Shabda if it is standing for Anushaya Shesha Karma as well? Because you are claiming that the Janma is due to Karma. एंड आई एम सेइंग दैट इट इज ड्यू टू द जन्म इज ड्यू टू कंडक्ट आचरण. नाउ यू आर सेइंग नो चरण शब्द स्टैंड्स फॉर कर्म ऑल्सो. देन चरण शब्द इफ इट स्टैंड्स फॉर कर्म ऑल्सो देन चरण एंड कर्म बोथ आर देर देन दिस चरण शब्द विल बी फ्यूटाइल. श्रुति वुड नॉट हैव यूज द चरण शब्द. इट वुड बी अनर्थ मीनिंगलेस आनर्थक्यम इति चेत न वाय तदपेक्षत्वात् मीनिंग चरण शब्द इज नॉट इन इट्स ओन मीनिंग ओनली देन. दैट इज वॉट द क्लेम मेड बाय द पूर्वपक्षी. सो सिद्धांति सेज नो बिकॉज कर्मसु तदपेक्षत्वात् बिकॉज इन द कर्म ऑल्सो आचरण इज इंपॉर्टेंट. इट इज नॉट ओनली कर्म बट द वे द कर्म इज डन दैट इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. सो चरण चरणस्य अपेक्षत्वात् आचरणस्य अपेक्षत्वात् इवन इफ कर्म इज देर आचरण ऑल्सो विल डिफाइन एज टू वॉट कैंड ऑफ जन्म. सो कर्म इज डन बट इफ कर्म इज डन विथ अ पर्टिक्युलर कंडक्ट इट हैज मोर मी मोर फल. इफ इट इज डन विथ अ विथ अ यू नो लेसर श्रद्धा इत्यादि आचरण इज नॉट गुड देन वॉट विल हैपन द सेम कर्म विल नॉट गिव अ सेम रिजल्ट. देर फोर आचरण इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. चरण शब्द इज नॉट मीनिंगलेस. सो चरण शब्द बिकॉज इट स्टैंड्स फॉर अनुशय देर फोर अनुशयवान जीवा विल हैव संसरण और दि पंचमाहूति एटसेट्रा. श्रुति इज एक्सप्लेन बाय दि सिद्धांति एंड देन पूर्वपक्षी चरण इफ इट इज इन दि अनुशय मीनिंग ऑल्सो एंड यू आर टेकिंग ओनली अनुशय देन चरण विल बी इन इट्स स्वार्थ विल बी मीनिंगलेस. इट इज नॉट सो वाई बिकॉज चरण शब्द ऑल्सो रिटेन्स इट्स स्वार्थ मीनिंग एंड आचरण इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दि संसारी जीव टू टेक अनदर जन्म बेस्ड ऑन द कर्म बट ऑल्सो ऑन द कर्म डन एंड विथ अ पर्टिकुलर आचरण एज वेल. सो दैट इज द तदपेक्षत्वा देर तस्य चरणस्य आचरणस्य स्वभावस्य अपेक्षत्वात् दैट डिपेंडेंसी इज ऑल्सो देर. दैट इज सूत्रार्थ. सो अनर्थक्यम इति चेत न तदपेक्षत्वा तदपेक्षत्वा इज अ समास. ननु चरणश्रुतेः मुख्याचारार्थ परित्यागेन अनुशयार्थकत्वे आनर्थक्यम् इति चेत् न. सो व्हेन यू से उपलक्षणार्थ उपलक्षण मीन्स चरण शब्द मीन्स चरण एज वेल एज अनुशय बट दि सिद्धांती हैज ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड ओनली अबाउट अनुशय. ही हैज नॉट टॉक्ड अबाउट चरण. सो इन दि अर्लियर सूत्र अनुशयवान अनुशयवान हैज गमन गच्छति. सो रौहति रौहति गच्छति अनुशयवान दैट इज व्हाट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन इन अनुवृत्तिस. अर्लियर सूत्र हैज हैड रौहति देयर एंड दैट रौहति इज अनुवृत्ति हियर एंड यू कैन से अनुशयवान रौहति शेषकर्मवान रौहति गच्छति गोस टू वन लोका एंड कम्स बैक सम लोका बेसिकली गोस टू अदर लोका एंड हैज अ रिटर्न ऑल्सो थ्रू डिफरेंट पाथ एंड दैट इज हु अनुशयवान. सो यू हैव नॉट टेकन चरण इन टू अकाउंट. देर फोर पूर्वपक्षी सेइंग इफ चरण इज इन बोथ मीनिंग्स ननु चरणश्रुते मुख्याचारार्थ परित्यागेन इवन इफ इट इज इन बोथ मीनिंग्स यू दि सिद्धांती हैज टेकन ओनली दि अनुशय मीनिंग. देर फोर चरणश्रुते मुख्याचार अर्थ परित्याग हैज टेकन प्लेस. मुख्यार्थ परित्याग हैज बीन डन. Although it is upalakshana, it covers both meanings. You have taken only anushaya meaning. Therefore, acharana, charana, acharana meaning, which is the mukhyartha, which is the vachyartha of the charana shabda, that has not been taken into account. Therefore, mukhya achara artha parityaga has taken place. And tena, mukhya achara artha parityagena, anushaya artha katve. Then, the shabda has only the charana, ramaniya charana gata, श्रुतिगत चरण शब्द से अनुशयार्थकत्वे. देन दी चरण शब्द इन दी रमणीय चरण श्रुति हैज ओनली अनुशयार्थ. सो व्हेन इट हैज ओनली अनुशयार्थ अनुशयार्थकत्वे सति अनर्थक्यम. कस्य अनर्थक्यम चरण शब्द से चरण श्रुते दैट रमणीय चरण दैट चरण शब्द श्रुति इज पर्पसलेस अनर्थक्यम इति चेत न सेज दि सिद्धांती. वाय इष्टादि कर्मणाम आचार निर्वर्तत्यत्वेन निर्वर्त्यत्वेन बाय अकम्प्लिशिंग वॉट इष्टादि कर्म आचार निर्वर्त्येन निर्वर्त्यत्वेन बाय द अकम्प्लिशमेंट ऑफ इष्टादि कर्म हाउ थ्रू द आचार सो बाय द अकम्प्लिशमेंट ऑफ द आचार ऑफ द इष्टादि कर्म सो देयर इज सम कंडक्ट ऑफ द पर्सन हु इज डूइंग इष्टादि कर्म सो इष्टादि कर्मणां आचार निर्वर्त्यत्वेन चरणापेक्षत्वात् सो वाइल डूइंग द कर्म सम आचरण हैज बीन फॉलोड बाय द कर्मी सो दैट इष्टादि कर्मकारी व्हाट वाज द शब्द यूज वाज इष्टादिकारी सो इष्टादिकारी जीवा हैज यूज सम आचरण ड्यूरिंग द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ इष्टपूर्ति कर्म सो इष्टादि कर्मणाम आचार निर्वर्त्यत्वेन एंड द कर्म इट्सेल्फ व्हाट इज इट डूइंग द कर्म इज अकम्प्लिशिंग अ पर्टिकुलर आचार आल्सो व्हाइल डूइंग द कर्म देयर इज सम कंडक्ट दैट इज वन वे टू लुक एट इट बट व्हाट इज द वृत्ति सेइंग वृत्ति लिटरली इट इज सेइंग व्हाइल परफॉर्मिंग द नॉट व्हाइल with the performance of the ishtadi karma some conduct is also going to result that is why nitya sandhya should be done not only for dharmacharana which itself is sandhya but it builds on itself so both build on each other acharana will build upon ishtadi karma performance and ishtadi karma performance will build on acharana So I have taken one way, I have explained the meaning initially in the sutra in one manner. Now in the vritti you see the other manner also, which can be taken as the main meaning as well. I would see it as both build upon each other. If you have a particular conduct, then you will feel like doing more dharma. Then because it is samskara, samskara is going to rule over a particular conduct. Then if we have a particular samskara manifesting in particular acharana, then that acharana will help us do more and more dharma karya sandhya ityadi karma then the sandhya ityadi will build upon more samskara which will result in a better acharana so they build upon each other so ishtadi karmanam achara nirvartyatvena so ishtadi karma results in a particular accomplishment of acharya acharana means acharana which is the meaning of the charana shabda in the रमणीय चरणाश्रुति सो वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इज दैट अ पर्टिक्युलर कंडक्ट इज ऑल्सो एक्सपेक्टेड एंड देयर बाय चरण अपेक्षत्वात् एंड बाय चरण अपेक्षा इट इज शोइंग द अदर वे फ्लिप साइड मीनिंग ऑल्सो बोथ आर नीडेड एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द धर्म कार्य विथ अ पर्टिक्युलर कंडक्ट बिल्डिंग अपॉन ईच अदर दे विल पुट टूगेदर रिजल्ट इन some kind of a adrishta which will lead to particular loka and particular janma after that therefore charana shrutehe arthavattvam ityartha therefore charana shruti ramaniya charana shruti has meaning it is purposeful it is purposeful even in its swartha meaning mukhya artha there is no mukhya artha parityaga there is no lakshana done Lakshana has to see. Lakshana is a dosha when mukhyartha is applicable. If the shabda bodha is taking place and it is meaningful, meaning it in the context it has makes sense. It has sense. It makes sense. Then lakshana should not be used. Only when the meaning is contradictory or it does not make sense. It is contradictory to some other shruti, or it does not make sense, or it does not make. Shabda bodha itself does not take place then lakshana should be used then it is not a dosha then that is how the mimamsa has to be done but if at all shabda bodha is taking place and it makes sense in the context also with the tatparya also it is setting in there is no contradiction with another shruti then lakshana should not be done so if at all mukhyachara artha parityaga has taken place and the चरण श्रुति इज इन अनुशया अर्थ देन देर वुड बी लक्षणा काइंड ऑफ अ दोष बाय मुख्यार्थ परित्याग, मुख्यार्थ परित्याग शुड नॉट टेक प्लेस बिकॉज चरण इज ऑल्सो मेकिंग सेंस. नाउ सिद्धांति सेज दैट नो, देर इज नो मुख्यार्थ परित्याग बिकॉज मुख्यार्थ इज ऑल्सो नीडेड एंड अनुशयार्थ इज बाय उपलक्षण इट इज ऑल्सो नीडेड. देर इज नो लक्षण डन, इट इज उपलक्षण. सो उपलक्षण मीनिंग डज नॉट हैव मुख्यार्थ परित्याग. मुख्यार्थ एंड उपलक्षणार्थ बोथ आर टेकन इन टू अकाउंट. दिस इज हाउ दी श्रुति इज मेकिंग सेंस. वस्तुतः कर्म कर्मचरणयोः न भेदः इत्याह. नाउ हैविंग एक्सप्लेन दिस इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्शन, नाउ व्हाट इज द रियल सिद्धांत. बिकॉज कार्ष्णाजिनी ही आचार्यः मन्यते, दिस वॉज द एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवन बाय द सूत्रकार. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन by quoting Karshnajini Acharya, the refutation of the Purvapakshi has taken place. But what is the Mukhya Siddhanta? That Mukhya Siddhanta, if it is mentioned, then another Acharya's name wouldn't be taken. Like we have seen the example in Vyakrana, Lopa Shakalyasya. So Lopa Shakalyasya means Shakalya Acharya Manyate, Lopaha. Atra Lopaha Kartavya iti. What does it mean? Panini Acharya na Manyate. Panini Acharya says that Lopa need not be done. It is not mandatory. So what does it mean? Vibhasha, optionally. So now here also similarly when Karshnajinihi Manyate has been mentioned, then the Sutrakaraha na Manyate. Meaning Sutrakara says that it is all right, but then that is not the Mukhya meaning. So our Siddhanta, Parama Siddhanta can be different. Therefore now Vastutaha Karmacharanayoho न भेद इत्याह. सी कंडक्ट लीड्स टू कर्म एंड कर्म लीड्स टू कंडक्ट. सो देर इज अ सर्कल देर, इट हैज अ म्यूचुअल बिल्ड अपॉन ईच अदर. दिस इज व्हाट वी सॉ. नाउ व्हाट इज बीइंग सेड इज दैट कर्म एंड चरण आचरण हैज नो डिफरेंस एट ऑल. कर्म इटसेल्फ इज आचरण. व्हाट इज आचरण? व्हेन यू लुक एट समबडीज आचरण, व्हाट यू से? यू लुक एट हिज कर्म एंड देन यू से दैट दिस इज हाउ हिज आचार इज. So where is the difference between karma and achara? There is no difference between karma and charana. So this is how the explanation is given. Vastutaha, in reality, karma and charana, acharana have no bheda. They are samanarthaka. Ityaha sukruta duskrute eveti tu badarihi. Sukruta duskrute eveti tu badarihi. So badarihi says what? Badari acharya manyate. What? Sukruta duskrute eva. इति एव व्हाट एव चरण शब्देन उच्यते. सुकृत दुष्कृते, द सुकृत सुकृते सुष्टु कृत शोभन. व्हाट इज द शोभन? मीन पुण्यकर्म. दुष्कृत इज व्हाट इज पापकर्म. सो सुकृत एंड दुष्कृत इन द्विवचन सुकृत दुष्कृते एव इति तु बादरिहि. सो बादरी आचार्य सेज व्हाट? सुकृत एंड दुष्कृत, पुण्यकर्म एंड पापकर्म एव. एव व्हाट? चरण शब्देन उच्यते. चरण शब्द हैज आचर आचार आचरण, रमणीय चरण चरण शब्द, दैट मीन्स ओनली पुण्य एंड पाप कर्म. पुण्य एंड पाप ऑल्सो हैव बोथ मीनिंग. पुण्य एंड पाप इज इन द फला मीनिंग ऑल्सो एंड इन द कर्म मीनिंग ऑल्सो. कर्म ऑल्सो व्हाट? कर्म ऑल्सो हैज बोथ मीनिंग्स. पुण्यकर्म पापकर्म मीन्स the action which is done and phala also. So in the context it has to be taken. So here sukruta duskruta are in the karma action meaning. So it's good karma and meaning punya, the karma that will lead to punya as phala and karma that will lead to papa as phala, both are what? The meanings of the acharana shabda itself. So acharana shabda, the ramaniya charana there itself means that one who has punya karma, they are ramaniya because it means sukruta. Eva iti tu badarihi, badari acharya says so. So badari acharya sukruta duskrute eva charana shabdena uchyate iti manyate. Badari acharya says that sukruta duskruta are the meaning of charana shabda. In the ramaniya charana shruti, charana shabda has the meaning of punya and papa karma itself. So there is what? No bheda. Karma charanayo bhedaha nasti. There is no bheda between the karana and karma and the charana shabdas. Loke ishtadikarini, and it is explained further as loke ishtadikarini dharman charati iti karma charanayo ho abhedena prayoga darshanat. Because in the world, what do you see? When you look at the way people use sentences, phrases, what do they say? Dharmam charati. Oh, look at this. Devadatta dharmam charati. What does it mean when you say that Devadatta? When someone says Devadatta dharmam charati, meaning he has dharma achara, he follows dharma. His conduct is what? He conducts in such a fashion that it is the way a dharmika purusha will have conduct. Therefore, dharman charati, when you say, dharma means what? Karma itself. So, dharman charati meaning has a dharmika acharana, meaning he does dharma karya, dharma karma. And who is this Devadatta? When they look at him and say, he follows dharma, his conduct is of a dharmika. So when they are making such a statement with respect to Devadatta, this Devadatta is Ishtadhikari Devadatta. So Loke Ishtadhikarini, who is that? Devadatta. So you say Ishtadhikarini Devadatte Dharman Charati with respect to him, Vishaya Saptami. Ishtadhikarini Vishaye, in the subject matter or with respect to this particular person who is doing Ishtapurta Ityadi Karma, is Ishtadhikari Devadatta. With respect to him, people say what? Dharmam Charati. He follows Dharma. He conducts himself in such a manner that Dharmika is used. Therefore, Dharmam Charati Acharati. So, Charana. Charana Shruti. Ramaniya Charana is in the sense of what? That Acharana. Ramaniya Charana is Bahuri. Ramaniya charanam acharanam yesham te ramaniya charanaha. So those who have ramaniya achara, they are called as ramaniya charanaha. And here dharmam charati means what? Same meaning. Ramaniya charanaha. If you convert it into a noun and make a samasa, then dharmam charati. Kaha dharmam charati? Devadatta. Ataha Devadatta ramaniya charanaha. You can say that. So where is the difference there? And who is Devadatta? Ishtadhikari. So, only because Devadatta is doing Ishtapurta Ityadi Dharma Karma, therefore he is said to be Dharmam Charati. He is addressed in this manner, Dharmam Charati, meaning he is Ramaniya Charanaha. Iti Karma Charanayoho Abhedena Prayoga Darshanat. In the world, we have seen such Prayoga, we keep on seeing such things as to Karma and Charana, Acharana have no difference in meaning Abhedena. There is a prayoga in abheda arthaka of karma and charana shabdas. Ataha ishtadhikarinam chandralokam gatanam punar avarohartham anushayahasti iti siddham. So finally, what does it mean when you say karma and charana have the same meaning? Purapakshi is saying that charana, those who have charana, acharana, a particular acharana, they can have janma, punaravritti, avaroha, punaravaroha, meaning punaravritti, punarjanma. But those who have shesha karma need not have janma. Only this acharana is going to lead to karma. So answer is to janma. So the answer given is atha ishtadhikarinam. The ishtadhikari, ishtapurta karma, those who have done, they go to chandraloka swarga. So chandralokam gatanam, those who have gone to chandraloka ityadi loka. This is just a sampling. Need not be only this loka, can be any loka. Need not be punya loka also, it can be papa loka also. It is upalakshana. This is all a sampling as to how there is janma. The janma may not be in the same fashion. The sampling is of the panchamahuti in the panchagni vidya. It can be in another way also, as to punarjanma is taking place through different marga. There is a jiva who is going to take birth. But here, specifically what is being quoted here, the third adhyaya is sadhana adhyaya, and the sadhana adhyaya here, particularly vairagya in the first pada, that is the focus. So vairagya will be resultant even with the punyaloka, swargaloka reaching, meaning even if the person reaches the swargaloka, this jiva would be very tempted. Oh, let me go to swargaloka, let me do ishtadi karma and attain swargaloka, chandraloka, ityadi. So even with the punya, there will be punaravaroha, punaravrutti, because the swargaloka punya, the punya which resulted in swargaloka, will exhaust. And after exhaustion, there what will happen? Jiva will have to take birth. And the way the description is made about the Jiva taking birth, that itself from Swargaloka, Avaroha from Swargaloka itself will cause Vairagya. What to talk about the Narakavasa or Janma from Naraka, Avaroha or however it is, whether it is Avaroha or basically Punaravruti, whether one will climb down or climb up from Naraka, wherever the Jiva has to go further, that kind of a journey would cause more Vairagya. So we can take in that sense that Chandraloka Gata Jiva is Upalakshana, it can be any Loka. So Atha Ishtadikarinam Chandralokam Gatanam Jivanam Punaravarohartham Anushayasti iti Siddham. So what is really needed for Punarjanma of this Jiva and this Jala Sukshma Mahabhuta Sabbadda Jiva taking Janma, Jala becoming Jiva in the Panchamahuti, what is needed is Anushaya. Anushaya asti iti siddham. Anushaya is Shesha Karma. Jiva has Sanchita Karma which is pending, out of which Janma, the karma which is ready to fructify will be put together into Prarabdha, and then such kind of a Janma will be given where Prarabdha Bhoga can take place. Therefore, Punar Avarohartham, this Chandraloka Gatanam Jivanam, who are those Ishtadikari Jivas, they have Punaravaroha, and for Punaravaroha what is needed? Anushaya is needed, Shesha Karma is needed, and that is there. Anushaya Asti iti Siddham. Because Acharana and Karma are in the same meaning. If Purvapakshi's Acharana is there, Shesha Karma is not there, or Shesha Karma will not lead to Janma, then Shesha Karma and Acharana have the same meaning. Therefore, mean Karma and Acharana have, Charana have the same meaning, and Shesha Karma is also Karma, therefore Charana and Shesha Karma will also have the same meaning, and thereby if you say the Charana is there, then yes, that will lead to Janma. Shesha Karma is there, Charana is there, and therefore Anushaya being there, Anushayavan Ramhati Gachati Asti iti Siddham. Now the next Adhikarana is being introduced. This Adhikarana is over, Krutatya Adhikarana is over. Anishthadi Karya Adhikaranam. So now Anishthadi Karya Adhikarana starts with an introduction as Purvam Ishtadikarini Eva Chandralokam Gachanti iti Uktam Tadayuktam. Purvam Ishtadikarinaha Eva Chandralokam Gachanti iti Ayuktam. So iti Yaduktam Tadayuktam. So what he is saying is, whatever has been said earlier, claim made by the Siddhanti. What is that? Purvam Ishtadikarinaha Gachanti. Prathama Bahuvachana. Ishtadikarinaha, those who are conducting Ishtapurti Karma, they alone, eva, who goes to Chandraloka? Only those who have done Ishtapurta Karma. So those who have done Ishtapurta Karma, they alone will go to Chandraloka, not others. This is the claim made by the Siddhanti. So Purvam Ishtadikarinaha Eva Chandralokam Gachanti Iti Uktam. So Iti Uktam Tadayuktam. So you can add, Tad is there, so Yat can be added. Yad Uktam Tadayuktam. What has been said, that is not right, says the Purvapakshi. And what has been said, only those who have done Ishtadik Karma, those Ishtadikari, Ishtapurta Karmas, those are Ishtadikari, and they alone go to Chandraloka, Swargaloka, Ityadi. Very Punya Lokas basically. Tad Ayuktam, that is not tenable, that is not right interpretation. Why? Anishtadikarinaha api gachanti ityakshepa sangatya idamaha. Purvapakshi says, not only Ishtapurta Karma Karis, those who have done Ishtapurta Karma, but even those who have not done Ishtapurta Karma, they also go. Anishtadi Karinapi, meaning those who have not done Ishtadi Karma, they have done some other karma. They have not done Ishtapurta Karma, meaning they have not done Punya Karma at all. They also go to Chandraloka. Iti Akshepa Sangyata. This is the Akshepa made, and therefore there is an Akshepa Sangati to this Adhikarana, and thereby Anishtadi Kari Adhikaranam. Anishtadikarinam api chashrutam. So, it is a Purvapaksha Sutra. सिद्धांत नोड़ सिद्धांत सूत्र पूर्वपक्ष सूत्र अनिष्टाधिकारिणाम अपि च श्रुतम अनिष्टाधिकारिणाम अपि च श्रुतम वॉट चंद्रलोक गमनम श्रुतम और चंद्रलोक गति ही श्रुता. सो व्हाट इज दैट दोज हु हैव नॉट डन इष्टपूर्त कर्म दे आर अनिष्टाधिकारी जीवास. सो समासा कैन बी सीन इन मल्टीपल वेज. विल टेक द सिंपलेस्ट वे एज टू न इष्टाधिकारी इति अनिष्टाधिकारी. सो वॉट एवर वॉज एस्टैब्लिश इन द अर्लियर समास एज इष्टाधिकारी इष्टपूर्त कर्मास दोज हु डू दे आर कॉल्ड इष्टाधिकारी तेषां चंद्रलोक गमनम अस्ति. चंद्रलोक गति ही अस्ति और चंद्रलोक गमनम अस्ति स्वर्गलोक. दे अटेन स्वर्गलोक चंद्रलोक. अनिष्टाधिकारी मीनिंग दोज हु हैव नॉट डन इष्टादि कर्म दे आर अनिष्टाधिकारी तेषां अपि च श्रुतम. व्हाट चंद्रलोक गमनम स्वर्गलोक गमनम श्रुतम. सो हियर वी विल टेक चंद्रलोक एज मेंशन. सो चंद्रलोक इज अ पुण्यलोक. जनरली इट इज सेड चंद्रलोक दे आर पितृलोक एंड ऑल दीज लोकास दे आर स्पीयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस. सो इट इज नीड नॉट बी अ पर्टिकुलर प्लेस एज पर द पूर्व मीमांसक. इट इज अ स्पीयर ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस. इट कैन बी हियर एंड नाउ आफ्टर द ड्रॉप ऑफ द बॉडी दो. इट कैन बी इन दिस वेरी वर्ल्डली स्पीयर वेयर देर इज एन एक्सपीरियंस इज एट अ डिफरेंट लेवल एट अ सटल लेवल. And there is no manushya sharira there. Some other sharira may be there. The stula sharira of manushya is not there. The same akara etc. may be there in the antakarna. Because going to pitruloka sat sambandha is there. So the pitru bhava is there. Without the stula sharira. So some kind of an understanding which is impressed upon the mind that I am connected with these kind of putra putris. With this family. That kind of an impression is carried in the antakarana, in the samskaras. So chandraloka gamana is there. Now anishtadi karinam apicha shrutam. So what you have interpreted as only ishta karma kari go to chandraloka is not right. And you have explained in that manner. However, Purvapakshi tells to Siddhanti that anishtadi kari, those who have not done ishta purta karma, they also have chandraloka journey. This is heard in the shruti itself, shrutam. And thereby what? Ishtadi karma is vyartha. That will be the meaning. Because if those who do ishtadi karma, ishtadi ishtapurta karma, they go to chandraloka. Those who do not do ishtapurta karma, they also go to chandraloka. Then what is the point of doing ishtapurta karma? Shruti will become vyartha. Thereby, Purvapakshi is showing some kind of an objection in that manner as to there is an issue here. With your interpretation, and then if your interpretation is not right and mine is correct, then what will happen? Shruti will become vyartha. Atra purvapakshe anishtadikarinam avisheshena chandraloka gatehe ishtadikaranam vyartham. Purvapakshi's perspective is what? This ishtak purta karma is vyartha. Nobody should do it. Why should anyone do it? It is vyartha. Why? Because those who do not do will also go to chandraloka. So Purvapakshe Anishtadikarinam Avisheshana, there is no Vishesha. Those who have done Ishtapurta Karma, they go to Chandraloka. So you will say, oh, only they go, then it is Vishesha. If they also go, then there is no Vishesha. Those who have not done Ishtapurta Karma, they will also go. Thereby Anishtadikarinam Avisheshana Chandraloka Gate, hey, because of Chandraloka Gati being their journey to Chandraloka being there for those who have not done Ishtapurta Karma also, there is no Vishesha, they cannot be separated out. Because you can say these have not done, these have done Punya Karma, some have not done Punya Karma, but both will have the same journey. Therefore, Ishtapurta Karma, that Punya Karma is waste, Vyartham. Siddhante, what does the Siddhante say? In the Siddhanta, Siddhante, Papinam Chandraloka Gatyabhavat Tadartham Ishtadikaranam Sarthakam Iti Phalabhedaha. Siddhanti says, I don't know where you get your sources, but it is not right that those who do not do Ishtapurta Punya Karma, they will get Chandraloka Vasa. That is not true. So, though, and what does it mean now? Anishta can be taken in another meaning also. Now, na ishtadikari means those who have not done ishtapurta karma. What is the other nanji meaning? We have taken the simplest meaning. Those who have not done ishtadikarma, meaning they are not papis. They have not done punya karma, that's all. We are not saying that they have done papa karma. But there are multiple ways to look at it. Now let's say sandhya vandana as a nitya karma. Those who do nitya karma, they are doing dharmacharana, but do they get punya? The Purva Mimamsaka says that if you do nitya karma, there is no punya. But if you do not do nitya karma, there is papa, pratyavaya dosha. Now, then why should anyone do nitya karma? Because to avoid pratyavaya dosha, one has to do nitya karma. This is the Purva Mimamsaka saying. Siddhanti, Vedanti, Uttara Mimamsakas agree. We agree that yes, there is something called as pratyavaya dosha, but pratyavaya dosha is not born of not doing nitya karma, but it is already accumulated in the earlier janma through papa karma, and it is fructifying in prarabdha every day. Every day the pratyavaya dosha will be countered by nitya karma. So if nitya karma is not done, it cannot be countering pratyavaya dosha which is already accumulated. So that is manifestation of pratyavaya dosha which is already accumulated. It is not freshly born out of nothing. Nothing cannot produce something. So not doing nitya karma cannot give rise to pratyavaya dosha, but figuratively we say that because nitya karma counters pratyavaya dosha which is already due to papa karma done in earlier janmas. Some particular kind of karmas, papa karmas. So they will result in dukkha if nitya karma is not done. And nitya karma not being done, pratyavaya fructifies. Therefore, pratyavaya dosha is a name given to it. It does not mean that pratyavaya dosha is a freshly born dosha. It is whatever papa phala is being born, that is not counted, and that gets the name of pratyavaya dosha because nitya karma is not done. And loosely we say that we are not doing nitya karma leads to pratyavaya dosha, which is figuratively acceptable, but if you do literal analysis, then not doing something means absence of something. Absence cannot give rise to something positive. This is the Siddhanta. Now, not doing is one part. So, not doing punya karma, here not nitya karma, but ishtapurta is not nitya karma, ishtapurta is punya karma, it will give chandraloka vasa. So anishtadi there nanch can mean another meaning also, meaning viruddhartha. So meaning one who is doing non-ishtadi karma. So who is that? Meaning doing papa karma. One who is not doing punya karma means one who is doing karma opposite to punya karma, that is viruddhartha. So therefore papa karma, and the vritti takes that meaning. Siddhante papinam chandraloka gatya bhavat. Meaning anishtadi kari are those who are doing karma opposed to ishtadi karma, ishtapurta karma, meaning opposed to punya karma, meaning papa karma, therefore papis. So siddhante papinam, not neutral, but those who are doing papa karma actively, those are papis. Siddhante papinam chandraloka gatya bhavat tadartham ishtadi karanam sarthakam iti phalaveda. Those who do papa karma, they do not have chandraloka vasa, they do not have chandraloka gati, therefore ishtadi punya karma sarthakam is meaningful. It is not that it is meaningless. Now the reason I explained the nitya karma is for another reason, to say that imagine you are one person is not doing nitya karma. Now nitya karma is ordained, so it is what, if it is ordained by the shruti, it has to be done. If it has to be done, the question should not be what will I get. Now the person who is not doing sandhyadi nitya karma, what is he doing at that time? There is a time slot given, you should be doing, meaning let's say nitya karma has to be done in both options, meaning udite juhoti, anudite juhoti. So when the surya udaya has taken place, then some shakhis consider as it has to be done after surya udaya has taken place. Some say that this nitya karma has to be done before the surya udaya. So both are valid pakshas. Whatever sampradaya one follows, one should do nitya karma at that time. Now if somebody is supposed to do nitya karma in that time slot every day and one is not doing, So you can one can say that, okay, I'll not get punya. That is all. Anyway, I'm not going to get punya. What is going to happen? Pratyavaya dosha, meaning which I already anyway I have accumulated, that will fructify. I'll get some dukkha. If one is accepting that, that is not the only case. The reason I brought it up is to look at this anishtadi having a different interpretation also with punya karma also. Not doing punya karma, what is that person doing then? So if somebody is not doing the prescribed karma and doing something else, one may be sleeping, one may be watching movies, one may be doing exercises, going out or whatever. So the some may be neutral karma, but doing something in the place of a prescribed karma itself is a papa karma really. Why? Because sleeping in that slot is not good. That will also give papa. When the Suryodaya is taking place, a person should get up before sunrise. That is the vidhi. Because in both pakshas, udite juhoti, anudite juhoti, even if one is supposed to do the nitya karma during sunrise or immediately after sunrise, one should have gotten up before sunrise. So what to talk about a person who in the Shakis who say that nitya karma has to be done before sunrise? Definitely that person should have woken up before, bath etc. has to be taken, achamana itya, all these should have, these swachhata karya should precede the Suryodaya is established. Therefore, if a person is doing anything else in that slot, including sleeping, that will result in papa. Surya has gotten up, but you have not gotten up, to put it in a poetic sense. So the person is sleeping when Surya himself has woken up, that is papa karma. So you can look at it in another manner, as not doing nitya karma is not leading to papa, but doing something else in the place of nitya karma is leading to papa. Thereby what will happen? Anishtadikari, even in the case of nitya karma also. So one who is not doing ishta karma, opposed to that one may be doing papa karma. So papis do not have chandraloka vasa. Therefore chandraloka vasa is sukha pradayaka, and since papis do not get that, therefore anishtadikari will not go to chandraloka, and thereby ishtadi karma has to be done. Therefore, ishtadikaranam sartakam. Sartak means arthena sahavartate iti sartakam sahabhauri. It has meaning. It is purposeful. Iti phalabheda. We will look at more in the next part. We will look at this part of the vritti in the next part. Amnayantaka samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandakaram apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Namaste. Thank you.